Hey friends, Pastor Kevin here. Hope you're doing well. This past weekend at church, I had mentioned to you that we are beginning a brand new sermon series this coming weekend, going verse by verse through the book of Revelation. And I wanted to connect with you in this video just as a way of trying to establish some context around the series and also passing along a few things that I hope will be helpful to you as you get ready for this brand new series that begins this coming weekend. You know, it's interesting, isn't it, that whenever we go through times of national or international, or in this case, global crisis like we have with COVID, that there are certain questions that have a way of tunneling to the surface. And it's not necessarily that everyone's asking the same questions, but there are common questions that keep showing up in our collective conversation. Questions like, is this the end? Like, is what we're going through right now, is this the beginning of the end? And if it is the end, am I ready? Am I ready to meet Jesus face to face? Maybe you can think back and remember when Y2K was a thing, when the calendar flipped from 1999 to the year 2000. And man, there were a lot of people who were hunkering down in their basement and with all the canned goods they could get their hands on and the non-perishable food items and these massive jugs and bottles of water. Man, they were ready for the end to come. And a lot of these questions came up at that point as well. And then we went through 9/11, and a lot of the questions came up again, and we saw this spike in religious and spiritual interest in these questions that were being asked. And here we are now going through COVID, and a lot of these questions are coming up yet again. And so as we journey through the book of Revelation, we want to see what the Bible has to say about questions like this. And even more than that, I hope as we go through this series together, that a journey through the book of Revelation will actually help to recalibrate us on what matters the most at a time like this. And I would even say helps to recalibrate us on who matters the most. So we're going to go through this series and pray that the Lord helps us to focus on Him, even in the midst of the chaos and everything that's going on in our world right now. You know, when you think about it, there's really only one main purpose behind the book of Revelation, and that is for us to worship Jesus. That as we go through this book, we're going to see that we have this incredible hope because our King is coming again, and He can come at any moment. And so we look forward with great anticipation and with great hope at the reality that He's going to come again for us. You know, this book of Revelation was not given to us to satisfy our curiosity about how the world's going to end. Its primary purpose is not to fill some desire within our heart for charts and diagrams and timelines and all that kind of stuff. And even as we go through this series, we're going to have our charts and our diagrams and our timelines in ways that I hope that they will be helpful. But the one primary purpose of this book is to show us that we are racing towards this moment in human history where we as believers will all together be gathered around the throne and we'll be singing, "Worthy is the Lamb." That's the purpose. We want to fill our hearts with worship of Jesus Christ. And so I pray as we go through this series that more and more our heart will be filled with gratitude and with love and with hope and with worship of our one true and coming King, Jesus Christ, the Lamb who was slain to take away the sins of the world. You know, there's also a secondary purpose for us as we go through this series in Revelation. And, you know, I'm sure that there are at least a handful of different understandings and interpretations within our own church family of how the book of Revelation will play out. And personally, I believe that that's okay. I do not think that our differences in interpretation when it comes to the book of Revelation need to be matters of division for us. I don't think that needs to be the case at all. There are many, many God-fearing, Jesus-loving, Bible-believing brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus Christ who interpret and understand the events described in the book of Revelation in very different ways. And so I just want to stress for us again as we begin this series that the book of Revelation is not given to us in order for us to debate our different viewpoints. It's given to us to unite us around the reality that Jesus Christ is coming again for us and that He ultimately is the hope that we have and He alone is worthy of all of our praise. And so I hope on some level that this series also has a way of modeling for one another among our own church family that we can have a unity in Jesus Christ, even amid the differences in interpretation, and that we can work hard toward this unity with one another in Jesus Christ at a time when our unity together is absolutely vital. It's vital for us within the church, and it's vital for those outside of the church to see that we are united around the one thing, around the one person that matters the most above all, and that is our glorious King, Jesus Christ. You know, when you jump into a series like this, you need a plan because this is a big book. If you take a look in your Bible, you can see for yourself, the book of Revelation is 22 chapters. So this is not a short book, nor is this a book for the faint of heart. In fact, if you're familiar with this at all, if you begin reading in chapter 1, verse 1, and through those first few sections in the book of Revelation, you find that this is a pretty intense book right out of the gate. I mean, the Apostle John just gives us these amazing pictures and visions of who Jesus Christ is and paints him in an absolutely glorious light. And then from there, like John just puts the pedal to the metal the whole way through the rest of the book. And so we need a plan going through this. So back in the spring, we got some feedback. I got some feedback from our flock leaders and our small groups who said, you know, sometimes when we go through bigger books like this in the Bible, it can be really helpful if we take some breaks along the way, maybe divide it into smaller chunks, and it just gives us a chance to catch our breath and maybe focus on a few other things and then come back to that series again a little bit later. And you know what? That makes perfect sense. Like, that's great feedback. And so that's exactly what we're going to do with the book of Revelation. We're going to go through a first part of it here early on, and then we're going to take some intentional and strategic breaks along the way that, again, give us a chance to catch our breath and think about what we're processing and how to apply it to our lives and how to apply it to our church and what it means for us moving forward, and then be able to focus on some other things that complement this main series. And then we'll come back and we'll jump into this main series in the book of Revelation. And so, flock leaders, small group leaders, excellent feedback. Thank you so much. That's exactly what we're going to do through the book of Revelation. All of that simply to say, I hope this is helpful to you. I hope it's helpful to us as we begin this journey together through the book of Revelation. Hey, praying for you, praying for us collectively as a church, that God would give us the grace to see with brand new spiritual eyes, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. See you Sunday. Worthy.